Hi, welcome back. In this session, we'll solve some examples related to quadrilateral sum of angles. The first problem, the four angles of a quadrilateral are in 3 is to 5 is to 7 is to 9 ratio. Find the angles. We know that the sum of four angles of a quadrilateral is nothing but equal to 360 degrees. So what I will do, since they are in ratio 3 is to 5 is to 7 is to 9, I will take them as 3x, 5x, 7x, 9x and sum them up, equate it to 360 degrees. I should be able to find out the value of x. Once I got the value of x, I'll substitute that to find out the angles. So my first step will be, let the four angles be 3x, 5x, 7x and 9x. We know that sum of four angles is equal to 360 degrees. But we can find out the sum from here also. So I can say 3x plus 5x plus 7x plus 9x equal to 360 degrees. That will give me 3 plus 5, 8, 8 plus 7, 15, 15 plus 9, 24. I will have 24x equal to 360 degrees. That will give me x equal to 15 degrees. If I know x equal to 15 degrees, I will have 3x as 45, 5x as 75, 7x is 105 and 9x equal to 135. So you want to cross check that, you can add all these angles and see that they are adding up to 360 degrees. 240, 315, 360. Okay, right. Let's move to the next one. Two angles of a quadrilateral are of measure 65 and the other two angles are equal. Find those angles. So let them be x. We know all four should add up to 360. Same type of problem. So I will say 65 degrees plus 65 degrees plus x plus x. Why it is x plus x? Because other the two angles are equal. Two of them are equal to 65 and remaining two are equal. So I don't know what it is. So I'm saying equal to 360 degrees. So this will be 130 degrees plus 2x equal to 360 degrees. We have to find out x value. So I will say 2x equal to 360 degrees minus 130 degrees, that is equal to 230 degrees. Therefore x equal to 230 divided by 2, nothing but equal to 115 degrees. So straightforward problems, both of them, just adding them and equating to 360 degrees. Now let us look at some interesting problems. First we will look at the left problem. We have ABCDE regular pentagon. What's the meaning of regular pentagon? In regular pentagon, all the sides are equal and all the angles are equal. If you look at the picture, you can see that AM is a angular bisector at BAE. Similarly, CP is a angular bisector at BCM. Now first let us try to find out what is the interior angle of a regular pentagon. So we know that sum of interior angles formula is n minus 2 into 180. This is sum of angles. Since all the angles are equal, if I divide that by number of sides, I will get my interior angle. That is nothing but equal to 5 minus 2 into equal to 3 into 180 degrees divided by how many sides we have? 5. 108. How we got it? We know sum of interior angles equal to n minus 2 into 180 because you can divide that into so many triangles and each triangle the angles add up to 180 degrees. Now, you know that all the angles are equal, so you can divide by the side, how many of them, divide by how many angles you have, you will get automatically each interior angle. That's nothing but equal to 108. Now, the meaning of that is the angle, this is 108 and The angle at D is also 108. And since this is an angular bisector, the angle here is 54 degrees and 54 degrees. Now what I have to find out from the problem, I have to find out what is the angle CPM. X is nothing but equal to angle CPM. That is what we have to find out. Now, if I know the angle PCM and PMC, then I can find out what is angle CPM. So what angles I need? I need PCM and also I know and also I want PMC. Okay. To find out PCM is easy because it's angular bisector. I can go ahead and say it is equal to 54 degrees. That is easy for me. But how to find out the angle PMC? To find out that, what we will do, we will consider this quadrilateral AMDEA. We have AM, MD, DE, EA. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, let's take it. We will say AM, D, E, A. If I consider that, or you can say AMDE is the quadrilateral. If I consider the quadrilateral AMDE, again the sum of angles should be equal to 360 degrees, right? So let us see, this becomes 90. We will check it right now. Okay. If I take that, I have 108 plus I have 54 degrees because it's an angular bisector, plus I don't know the angle at M. This is nothing but equal to 360 degrees because we know sum of angles of a quadrilateral equal to 360 degrees. That gives me, what is that angle? Angle CMP. Angle CMP gives me angle CMP equal to 360 minus of 108 plus 108 216 plus 54, that is 270 equal to 90 degrees. Now you know this angle is 90 degrees. Automatically, obviously, this angle also becomes 90 degrees because it's a linear pair. They both add up to 180 degrees. Now what is X? X is nothing but equal to 180 minus of angle CMP, that is nothing but 90 degrees, plus angle PCM, that is nothing but equal to 50 degrees. So I can say X equal to 180 minus of angle CMP, that is 90, plus angle PCM, that is nothing but equal to 54. If you simplify this, this is nothing but equal to 36 degrees. So angle CPM is nothing but equal to 36 degrees. How we have done that? We have to find out the value of X. To find the value of X, I have to consider the triangle PCM. If I want triangle PCM to use, I should know the remaining two angles, then only I can equate it to 180, find out the value of X. Sum of all the angles to 180 degrees. Now since at C, CP is an angular bisector, we know that interior angle is 108. We know that PCM is nothing but equal to 54. To find out angle PMC, what we have done, we have considered the quadrilateral AMDE. Once I consider quadrilateral AMDE, I know angle at A is 54, E is 108, D is 108. I don't know what is the angle at M, but I know all of them should add up to 360 degrees. So from that I can find out that angle CMP equal to 90 degrees. Once I know it's 90 degrees, now it's pretty easy because I can say 90 plus 54 plus X equal to 180. That will give me X equal to 36 degrees. Now let's look at this last problem. What we have here? we have a quadrilateral ABCD, and we have been told that AO, BO are the angular bisectors. How we know that? Because you can see that both the angles are given as equal. So that's the meaning is AO, BO are angular bisectors. Okay. Now we need to find out the angle of X. Two things we have. We have one quadrilateral, we have one triangle. Let's put down the equation for both of them. Angle A plus the angle B plus angle C plus angle D equal to 360 degrees. Now, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is 50 degrees. Angle D is 100 degrees equal to 360 degrees. That gives me angle A plus angle B equal to 360 minus of 150. That's nothing but 150 goes to the right side. You will have 210 degrees. We know now this is our first equation. Angle A plus angle B equal to 210. Now let us come to, this is what we have got from A, B, C, D. Now let's go to triangle AOB. In triangle AOB, you can see that angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle X equal to 180 degrees. But we know angle 1 is nothing but equal to angle A by 2 plus angle 2 is nothing but equal to angle B by 2 because they are angular bisectors, plus X equal to 180 degrees, or X equal to 180 minus of 1 by 2 into angle A plus angle B. What we have done, we have taken half common and we can write it as half outside, we can write half into angle A plus angle B. But we know from equation 1, angle A plus angle B is nothing but equal to 210. So I can say 180 minus of half into 210, that is nothing but 180 minus of 105, that is nothing but equal to 75 degrees. Now can you observe something? Excuse me. Can you observe that we know that the answer is 75, but without doing this, can you observe that this is nothing but equal to 100 plus 50 by 2? So the problem can be asked in another way without giving angle C, angle D. They may ask you to prove that angle AOB is equal to half of angle C plus angle D, which is exactly right, because the angle I got at X is 75, which is nothing but average of 150. So you know that now angle AOB is nothing but equal to half of angle C plus half of angle D. This we can use in problems, and also it can be asked to be proven without giving any values, numerical values. So that's about some problems related to sum of angles and finding out the angles of regular polygons. Specific to this session, it's of quadrilaterals, and also we have one problem on pentagon also. So see you in the next session. Thanks for visiting. Bye for now.